from Alto Capital is Tony Locantro. Tony, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew. On the start of a new financial year, so bring it on.
Indeed, and we saw a fair bit of tax loss selling last couple of weeks here, Tony.
Interesting that that came about. I guess the huge run in a lot of the specs came to an end, and some stocks that broke below their 20 cent issue price or placement price were hammered. You then had a lack of buyers coming in, and then you had technical breakdowns, and everyone got themselves into a bit of a tiz. But that's normally the phase where the smart money will come in and scoop up what I call to be wealth tokens, where the company's still great over the medium to longer term, but people have got to abide by their trading rules, and that means taking a loss.
As far as some recent news here, Tony, Mako Gold moving to 90% ownership here at Nupier.
Great story. I've been in there accumulating about as much as has been thrown at me. I just think that they're going to, looks as though they're going to build quite a decent resource in Côte d'Ivoire. All the drilling so far has been very positive, and the share price just tips toes through the tulips sideways in the mid eights. But I've seen stocks in the past like West African Resources that went around 5 cents forever and suddenly they break out. So I think that is a fantastic move for Mako, and it strengthens my resolve in the stock, and valuations are actually a lot higher than the 8.5 cent share price.
I know you're a big fan here of Nyrada. They've had some positive cholesterol reduction data out this week from a preclinical study.
Well, news to the ears of every junk food addict or person that's born with high cholesterol. Yeah, the inhibitor combined with Lipitor achieved a 65% reduction in overall cholesterol. That was as a combined therapy. But even as a monotherapy, Nyrada's inhibitor beat Lipitor 47 to 27%. And the cholesterol market is just ginormous. So yeah, the market didn't really respond based on the fact we'd just undertaken a 26 cent CDI capital raising. So it might be under a little bit of pressure. And one of the negatives to come from that announcement, if you call it a negative, was that clinical trials have been pushed out to mid next year. And that might cause some selling, but people have to realise that even in a year's time, you're still young. And, you know, there's just a rush to lose 80% on another crappy stock. But, you know, this is a great story. We hold a lot of the company, so I must disclose that. But really looking forward to the next set of trials. And interestingly, at the 35-day mark, the cholesterol was still falling. So they could have even tested it a bit longer. But great story, great one for viewers to research.
And what's going on with Alta Zinc, Tony, back below their recent placement price?
Well, the capital reconstruction, we did a 15-4, so you got one share for every 15. And that was belted by one seller, and then suddenly everyone else thinks the stock's a sell. So again, another one I've been heavily accumulating, as their zinc lead results in Italy have been fantastic. It's got fantastic management. It's close to zinc smelters. So even though it's not going to give you that adrenaline rush, both Mako and Alta Zinc, I call them my wealth token stocks, which will take a bit of time, but sometimes the biggest returns don't happen instantly.
And so start of a new financial year here this morning, Tony, who else are you keeping a close watch on?
Well, amongst all the technical breakdowns, and I always see when one of my stocks falls, everyone gets on Twitter and asks what's happening. Allumin actually fell below 20 cents down to about 17. And that to me is a high quality gold stock. Admittedly, their last set of drill results were a complete duster. They could not have reported worse results if they tried. But to me, their secondary project, Mount Palmer, isn't the main game. It's Mount Dimer. And it's the capabilities of that management team that worked under Bill Beament at one stage to deliver. So I have been adding to that stock personally around 17, 18 cents. Another one of my favorites, Adalta, is now down to 12 to 13 cents. That's a company into idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis and a collaboration with GE Healthcare. So that's another one I've been scooping up. And for the Powerball target at some stage, Red Metal's back to an attractive level. But Red Metal, my affiliation with that stock has lasted longer than both my marriages.
Very good, Tony. Good to see you. Thanks very much.
Absolute pleasure.